I have here a copy of your hotel registration.
Now you two can be beautiful and sexually desirable like me.
Is this your signature?
I refuse to answer.
Instead of being that fat, disgusting, foul-breathed, slimy, wallowing sow that you are.
There commenced evasive zigzag pattern, Commander. Set extra lookouts.
Aye, aye.
Maybe we blondes do have more fun.
Feel big. Drink pig.
No, Harry.
Morning,
I don't
good
like
morning,
films
morning,
on TV. They always cut them to pieces.
Get the crying thing, will you, Harry? I'm trying.
You'll never lose your man if you drink that.
No, Harry.
You will never lose your man if you drink fat cola. You'll never have to worry about losing him.
Puff, 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 puff. If you want the habit early, you must puff, puff, puff.
Harry, I want the crying thing.
I warn you again that you are under oath.
I refuse to answer on grounds that may tend to incriminate me.
He looks a lot older now.
Get a gun for everyone in your family. Remember, for family fun. Get your gun.
Come on, Harry. It's not exactly like the garden. See this. I want to see Charlie.
Well, I don't.
Switch it back, Harry.
I can't. Tony took the control gizmo.
Tony.
I don't want to see you, Charlie. Do you mind?
I do mind. Once in a million years is something I want to see. I want to see the flying thing.
I need a brand new scent.
Mr. You were seen by some 20 witnesses.
Oh, medical science has proven beyond.
Refused to answer on.
Approved toothpaste with wonder ingredient CIA 6.
Suggest that you search.
Dandruff, athlete's foot. And the common.
And I warn you again that you're under.
You suffer from aches and pains, upset stomach, ulcers.
And that you are under oath.
Disease, cancer, birth defect.
To answer on ground.
Mental illness, ringworm, poison. Tooth decay, acne, dandruff, athlete.
To answer on ground.
Measles, brain tumor.
Warning you, I might have to cite you for contempt of the Senate.
Smallpox, syphilis, plague, influenza.
May tend to incriminate.
Hepatitis and St. Vitus dance?
And I warn you again.
Well, you're in luck, friend. Pick a pack of Peter's perfidious pink pacifying placebo pills.
Refuse to answer.
Never lets you down, 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 but picks you up, up. Up, 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 up.
You are Mario Benedict, better known as Eggs.
I refuse to answer on the grounds that may tend to incriminate me.
And does your refusal to answer have anything to do with those bandages?
What bandages?
According to this hospital report, there are 23 bullet holes hidden under those bandages.
Well, I was cleaning my gun and it went off.
23 times?
Believe me, I was just as surprised as you are, Senator.
When do we eat around here? It's 8 o'clock, for crying out loud.
Dinner is when I finish watching.
You
it's like a crummy class reunion. Flo's Bows of 1952.
Hey, Tony.
I refuse to answer on the grounds that it may tend to incriminate me.
He looks 103 years old.
He hasn't aged a day.
I refuse to answer on the grounds that it may tend to incriminate me.
It wasn't white.
I don't give a damn who it was. I don't want to know. All I wanted something to eat.
I can make you a nice Western omelet.
Tend to incriminate me.
It wasn't Benedict.
I have here.
It wasn't Benedict.
What the hell do I care? I'm not the suspicious kind. If I was, would I have married a dame that's 3 months pregnant?
I refuse to answer on the grounds that it may tend to incriminate me.
I might have to cite you for contempt.
She just does that to get my goat. Should have never got married. Who needs
her? Oh, no, Tony, you're much better off. Believe me, I ought to know. I go home at night, nothing. No kids, no yelling, nothing.
What do you think, Harry?
About what?
Darlene, who does she look like?
Flo.
What are you talking about, Flo? She doesn't have Flo's mouth.
Now, what does her mouth remind you?
She's got your guts, Tony.
What?
It's the Mallor brothers.
What do you mean, the Mallor brothers?
I'm telling you, that's their car. And going anywhere, a 37 Rolls.
So it's a 37 Rolls.
Tony, that yellow stripe. They had a gun special. How you know? I drove them for 6 months.
They don't even know where I am. They've been in Puerto Rico for 20 years.
You know where they are.
Let's get the hard way.
And as one witness follows another, Senator Humble is getting the same answer Senator Kiesel got in 1950 and 1951, and Senator McClellan got in 1963 and 1964, the Fifth Amendment. There are rumors of a break, however, connected with the mysterious disappearance of George Blue Chips Packard. But so far, the government is keeping a tight lip.
Where's the light?
Dig nothing. You can't dig anything, you dig?
You mean, if I could be nothing, I would be everything?
You dig. I mean, like, that's why the establishment cats are not making it. They're digging the 9-to-5 bag. Rush to the city. What's happening in the news instead of what's happening in themselves.
Tony, what is she?
You dig?
Now I see what you mean. Everything we need is right here inside ourselves.
Hey, you dig. I mean, like, the vibrations are there, Dewdrop. You know, I really think we could make it, you and I. Really feel we could make it.
Tony, it's not a
Mallor
brother. It's an Indian.
He's not an Indian. He's bleeding.
Tony, I think it's one of those hippies.
That's it. And no lousy hippie is gonna make it with my daughter.
Daddy, that's not what he meant. I just met him in town.
I know what he meant. He wanted to...
Daddy, I don't think he even knows what he wants.
What is he, a faggot?
What's all this? Darlene? Who's this?
It's a hippie. She's bringing home hippies now.
Will somebody please help him? He's bleeding, for crying out loud.
Tony, come on.
You stay out of this, Flo. You spoiled her rotten already.
I spoiled her rotten.
Yes, look at her. Look at how she dresses. She doesn't even wear lipstick.
Come on, Tony. He's bleeding.
No daughter of mine is going to marry any hippie.
I'm talking about marriage, for heaven's sake.
Hippies don't even get married.
Your tailor, sitting Bull.
Once more, man.
You heard me. What do you go around dressed like that for?
Hey, we can't all be undertakers, man.
Don't push me, punk.
Tony.
It's okay. Violence is the sign language of the inarticulate.
What is he talking about? Do you know what he's talking about?
Of course.
Stash is only interested in nothing. He isn't taken in by our false values.
So how come you're driving a beat-up Rolls Royce? Why aren't you driving a beat-up Ford? Will somebody answer the door for crying out loud? How come, Mr. Stash? How does that go along with your values?
You'll believe it, Hetchy. Tony, look who's here. Hetchy.
Oh, yeah, I forgot you were going to drop in tonight. Let's go in the other room where we can talk.
Fuck crying out loud. Tony, what do you mean coming over this house?
Who's he? It's Angie. The last time I saw him, he was... Now he runs Oregon and Idaho. He's in the business, huh?
Next year, he gets the whole Northwest.
Next year, Darlene goes to Vassa.
That her in there? Very attractive.
Say, is that why you came tonight? To introduce the two kids?
No. Tony, God summons you. Tonight.
What is this, a gag?
God has a little job for you, Tony.
Oh, no, nothing doing. I'm retired. He let me retire 17 years ago when I married Flo. He released me from his jurisdiction.
You're never out of his jurisdiction.
He even gave me my new name. He said, you want to go legit? Okay, what's more legit than Banks? That's how I got my name, Tony Banks.
That's right, I was there.
Tony, Packard is turning state's evidence.
Packard?
He can hurt us bad, Tony.
He's power hungry. He thinks he can take over.
You gotta kiss him, Tony.
Are you nuts or something? Packard used to be my best friend. He was Darlene's godfather, for God's sake.
That's why God needs you. You're the only one Packard won't suspect.
Oh, no. If it's gotta be done, somebody else is gonna do it. I saved the tree once, remember? If it wasn't for me, the whole organization would have been finished 17 years ago.
Packard's in Rock Island Federal Pen. Maximum security.
I'm not gonna do it. Besides, how could I get to him if he's in the pen?
We get you in, we get you out.
Nobody can be arrested, tried, and sentenced that fast. It's impossible.
Everything's possible when God wants it.
Quick, Edgy, quick. I'm a member of the town council. Darlene is going to Bassett next year.
Damn it, Tony. When God says you go, you go.
When God says you go, you go.
You just can't walk in here and just tell me to kiss Packard and expect me to give up everything I've been working for all these years.
Tony, look, we're wasting time. Let's go.
Oh, you little bitch.
Come on now, Tony. You used to be good pals.
Man, he was a messenger. He's still a messenger.
Okay, I gave you the message.
The answer is no.
You know God don't take such an answer.
Well, this time he'll just have to.
In case you change your mind, we'll be waiting for you at Pier...
It used to be Pier 17.
We'll be there until it starts getting light.
You'll be wasting your time.
Good night, Mr. Banks.
Get in the house.
Good night, Tony.
Good night.
Never mind. What is it? That's impossible. I turned them off myself. All right. I'll take care of it.
Who's there?
I gotta go down to the office. Some idiot left everything on.
All right, Stanley.
Stanley? Stanley who? Pleasant dreams.
rid of the car.
Human body's a beautiful thing.
One little, two little, three little Indians. Four little, five little, six little Indians. Seven little, eight little, nine little Indians. Ten little Indian boys. One little, two little, three little Indians. Four little...
Hey, man, the cops.
Don't play.
Come on, get up.
Well, I love you. I really love you. Hey, are you a boy or a girl?
A girl.
Good. Because I'm a boy.
Very funny. Come on, get up, move it.
You know, man, nowadays you can't tell the boys from the girls.
Come on, move it, I said.
Look, man, we're paid up. We got 45 minutes left.
This ain't for sleeping. Move them.
Come on, get up. Move it, I said. Come on, get up or go to jail.
The drums and drums and drums. With your guns and drums and drums and guns. A-roo, with your guns and drums and your drums and guns, the enemy nearly. Oh, my darling dear, you look so queer, Johnny, I hardly knew you. Oh, where are them lakes that used to run? A-roo, a-roo. Oh, where are them lakes that used to run? Oh, where are them lakes that used to run?
Nobody move. Who's in charge here?
Nobody, man. In charge of means authority, and authority means power. You know what they say about power. Power corrupts. Amen. Hey, I love you, man.
Watch it.
We all love you.
Contempt of the law. Make a note of that, Perkins. Okay, search the place. You're all under arrest. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Move on. Let's go. Come on.
And as for this poster, I'm sure that you ladies who have consented to serve on the special committee will agree that it has a definite place in our beautiful, beloved township of Santa Delma. My husband has suggested that we use it for the basis of our anti-ugliness drive.
Ugliness is un-American.
I see that an urgent matter is at hand, so if you ladies will excuse me. Now, I do not know what brought you to my township, and I do not care to know. I just want to make one thing clear. You are not wanted here. We are proud of ourselves, our clean, upright citizens, senior and junior. We don't need you. We don't want you.
You are a backward step in the evolution of mankind.
When the citizens of Santa Delmar elected me to this office, they gave me a mandate to... What?
Is that Darlene?
Of course not. Really, don't you know your own daughter?
They have this stuff on them.
Thank you. Now, you were found with the following items in your possession. One bottle of...
Chinese Baileys, Mayor.
Cluck. One bottle of first
control pills.
Those are mine.
And what about this?
What about it?
Hey, put that out.
Smell it. It's a toke. Wait, smell it.
It smells like... like...
pumpkin!
All of you, and your pumpkins and your pills, you will be out of this township within the hour.
No, ma'am. We have the constitutional right.
Not in my town.
Unlawful assembly for the purpose of causing a disturbance is punishable by a 30-day jail sentence.
What shall it be? The highway or jail? You'd better make up your minds and quick.
See, something tells me we're not wanted. God love you, Mayor.
Darlene.
Goodbye, Mother.
I knew it was you.
Goodbye, Mother. Darlene, I will not permit you to run off like this with these people.
What do you mean, these people? They're beautiful, loving people who don't mean any harm to anyone.
I just don't want you to do something you're going to be sorry for. You're acting rashly.
I'm not acting rashly. Let's go, Stan.
Darlene.
I'm going with them, Mother.
No, you're not. You're both coming with me.
What?
Well, since Darlene is so dead set on staying with you, I guess the only way to make her come home is if you all come.
Hey, really groovy of you, Miss Banks. Now we won't be hassled by the police.
No, but you'll be hassled by Mr. Banks. I don't think he's going to like this.
Don't worry, Mother. You show them the way, and we'll stop at the office and break the news to Daddy.
What's the matter?
These machines are silly.
Look, you just press yes or no.
But suppose my answer is maybe.
My bunk. Take the top shelf.
I'm Leach.
Filipowicz.
Glad to meet you, Tony.
You read?
Shrink makes me. Says it's a release. I'm a recidivist.
What's that?
Habitual criminal. Been coming here on and off since 51. Mostly rape.
Cell block with his own personal stationery.
You painted this?
No, I bought it.
What are you in for?
I burnt my draft card.
Very funny.
Which is mine?
Take half the bottom shelf.
Half? There are three shelves.
Don't ask questions, kid. We get along. Okay?
You mean you didn't want to go in the army like a draft dodger? I don't like that. What are you, an anarchist or something? Don't you believe in America? I asked you a question. Don't you believe in America?
Yes, I just don't agree with everything it does.
Like what? Like what? Like doing your time in the army?
Don't you believe in the Bill of Rights, kid?
Please, I just don't want to talk about it now. Okay?
Nobody knows. He hasn't been to my work. Nobody at the country club's seen him. I even tried the barber shop.
He wasn't there?
I just told you. Oh, no. Next.
If only I could find the place that's right. He said something about driving to Santa Barbara.
How come his car's still there? He flew. The Santa Barbara, 23 miles? Mother, no one's seen Harry either. Mother, where are you going? Mother, just trying
to have they entered by force? Do you require police protection?
No, everything's fine. These are my guests.
I don't think you should. None of your neighbors, Mrs. Banks. With them around, property values will nosedive on this street.
Talk it over, darling.
Talk what over?
Mother, where are you going? Mother.
If only there were time enough, or word enough, or rhyme enough, I would take you there.
Not here right now. Can I take a message?
Hold tight. So this is Tony's girl, huh? A little kiss herself.
What do you mean?
Well, you and that Comanche look like you were never coming up for air.
Just who are you?
The name's Angie. We passed in the night. Last night. I can still close my eyes and see you.
Where'd you get your dialogue? From old Valentine's?
Cute. Very cute. Listen, why don't you drop by sometime when you're in San Francisco? The Green Street Tower Apartments.
I thought you wanted to talk to my mother.
Just tell her that your old man had to go out of town.
Where is my father? Do you know?
Baby, I know so much it's painful.
Remember when this place used to serve fresh vegetables from our own farm? Now everything tastes like plastic bags. Ready, Freddy, yeah.
I'd like to have a piece of Ready Freddy's action, I'll tell you that.
Hiya, Tony.
Give my best to Flo. I used to go with her before you came along.
I'm the man, Tony. How's Flo?
Fine.
Still a good dancer?
I didn't come here to talk about her dancing.
Okay, business. They got closed circuit TV here with a deaf mute reading lips. So we talk like this.
Is this good enough?
Shut up. Leach here will take care of your general health while you're here, right, Leach?
Okay.
I need no bodyguard. Just get me to you know who. I want to get the hell out of here.
You'll be out of here within 1 hour after you do the job. In the meantime, nobody can get near him. Nobody. It's maximum security. What's the matter, Professor? You're not eating.
I eat only brown rice.
Well, we'll get you all the brown rice you can eat.
They exercise pack it, don't they?
If they do, we don't know where or when. They even cook his food separately.
Then what am I doing here?
You're his best friend. He'll see you if you ask him.
How?
That's where the kid comes in.
This jerk?
This jerk is a technical genius. He helped develop the Latimer process at Berkeley.
Hey, look, man, I don't know what this is all about, but I've dropped out of your gadget civilization. I've renounced all science and technocracy.
Remember, Professor, we can make you 4F permanently.
It's not a question of 4F. What?
Your hair don't conform. Barbershop.
I protest. Look, you're violating the Bill of Rights, Article 4, also known as the Fourth Amendment of the Constitution. Are you here, sweetheart?
Open the door. Be glad, baby.
What are you doing here?
Where is he? What's happened to him?
You're bending the velvet.
It's something to do with a tree, isn't it? That's why you and Hetchy came to the house.
Look, lady, go home and relax, huh? Bake a chocolate cake.
What does God want with him after all these years?
Well, you beat it already. I'm expecting somebody.
Hey, this is sweet. Ah, it's a lot fleshier than when Hetchy lived here.
The age of electronics. Have a heart. I've been lining up this deal for 6 weeks.
You're cute.
I know.
You know what? I bet you're a good dancer.
I'm a good everything.
Prove it.
Okay.
Where's my husband? Where's Tony?
Let go.
Tell me where he is.
Let go. What are you, some kind of nut? I hear you, baby. Now, look, she's coming up in the elevator, so you go down the stairs.
I'm not leaving. I want to know what's going on. I want to see God.
You can't.
Take me to God. I'm not leaving until I find out what's going on.
Okay, okay. But please, wait outside until you see a redhead leave. A beautiful redhead.
I'm not waiting outside.
For the love of... She'll be here in a second. What are you doing?
Guess.
She's here.
So, when she sees what she'll see, she won't stay.
Well, please. Just a minute, baby. Tony's kid? Well, what are you doing here?
Why do you call him Tough Tony? And where is he?
Look, I'm expecting somebody. You gotta give a guy a little notice.
Where's my father?
So on your way, huh? I'll call you.
This is wild.
Small, but mine.
You're cute.
I know. So are you.
Your doorbell's ringing.
I hear it.
I'll leave if you want me to.
Oh, no. You just stay right there. This is a recorded message.
I am out and will call you when I get back.
In a couple of days. If you want to leave a message, speak now.
Listen, you crumb. I don't take this kind of treatment from nobody. The next time you call me, just forget it.
Okay, buddy, move it. I said move it. You can't stay here. Listen, you, get this crate out of here. Please, officer.
I'm sorry if I spoiled anything.
Nah, she was just trying to sell me a set of encyclopedias.
Hey.
Well, to us.
To us.
Stand still, will you? I want to talk to you.
I can't stay.
What?
There's somebody waiting for me downstairs. Call me.
Someone wait? And you let me send her away? Do you know how long I've been working on that broad? 6 weeks! 6 solid weeks! Damn it!
Angie, darling, is she gone?
Hello, Mother.
Oh, hello. I was just,
I thought something had happened to Daddy.
Well, it has. Well, that's why I'm here.
It's all right. I understand about such things. I just think you might have found someone more mature.
Wait, it's not what you think. God sent for your father.
No!
Not that God, dope.
Will you tell her about the tree, or do I?
What are you talking about? What tree?
All right. See for yourself. The tree. That's me. I run Oregon and Idaho.
I don't understand.
Your father was once part of the tree, but he quit before you were even born.
Nobody quits the tree.
Tony did.
Tony did. Tony did. You make it sound like he kicked the habit, like it's a disease or something. Look at it. This happens to be the most important organization in the world. Except maybe for the Pentagon. And we're more efficient. Do you know what'd be going on in this country without the tree? Chaos, that's what. Every hothead with an itchy finger would be extorting somebody. Every storekeeper with a plate glass window wouldn't be able to sleep at night. But with a tree, nobody has to worry. A guy has a laundry, he knows it won't blow up. A guy owns a restaurant on a highway,
He don't have to worry about the highway being detoured someplace else.
The protection racket, honey.
So what's wrong with protection? Ours is a violent society.
Stop mixing the girl up. Look, the one at the top is God. He sent for your father to do something, I don't know what. So I wanted to get to God to ask him to call it off. But the only way I could was if Angie took me. So that's why I was doing what I was doing.
Huh? Take us both to God.
Are you kidding? You want me walking around with my head under my arm?
Please?
I'll take one of
them. Okay.
Her.
Let it down.
Stash, this is Angie. Angie, this is Stash.
What's happening?
What'd you say?
Hey, listen to this. Gregory fought the impulse. He said no. The impulse said yes. Then something gave way. He dug his heels into her. He lashed her with the whip. But the horse still wouldn't move.
Will you shut your yap? I'm trying to concentrate. How's it coming, Professor?
Okay. I'm all flurry. Kid.
Thanks, darling.
Chips?
Yes.
Packet. Blue chips. Can you hear me, blue chips?
Even if he can hear you, he can't talk to you, Tony.
Tony?
Packet. If you can hear me, touch the thing with a thing.
Thing with a thing.
Here, Tony, let me. Mr. Packard, if you can hear us, then take any piece of metal and touch it to the speaker connection in the back of your TV.
You guys look ridiculous talking into a radio.
Why don't you shut up? Packard? Is it working or not? Touch the wire. Touch the wire.
I am touching it. I am touching the wire.
It works. It works. Professor, you're beautiful. Boy, Blue Chips, it sure is good hearing your voice.
Tony, what the hell are you doing here? I thought you gave up the business.
Shh, Blue Chips, we're on the radio.
Tony, how did you rig a gimmick like this?
You like it? I got a technical genius in myself.
He can't play blackjack, but he can sure play the radio.
We could play here.
In yourself? You're a match. I can't come to your cell.
I can arrange it.
Sure.
You want to bet I can arrange it? You want
to
bet?
Well, I wouldn't bet with you, Blue Chips. You took me to the cleaners too often.
I'll give you 2-1.
5-1.
You're on. What's the bet?
You name it.
No, you name it.
$5.
$2,000.
You're on.
Tell me, why you want to kiss me?
Kiss you? What would I want to kiss you for? You're my friend.
I told you a long time ago that we could have taken God for the entire thing. Now he's too big and he's got you doing his dirty work. It's disgusting.
I swear, I haven't seen God in years. Who do you think you're talking to, for crying out loud? This is Tony.
I know this is Tony. And I feel sorry for this is Tony, because when God finds out this is Tony, couldn't kiss this is Packard. He's gonna have a lead suit for this is Tony.
Blue Chips, I swear. You got the wrong idea, I swear.
On your daughter's life? On your daughter's life?
On my daughter's life.
I feel sorry for you, Tony. Give my best to Flo and Darlene. Over and out.
P.S. I might be here longer than I thought.
What are you doing? No. Tony, sit down.
I am sitting.
Okay, well then, stay seated. I mean seated. Now, Tony, have you ever heard of acid?
Acid?
LSD. It's a drug. It's odorless, tasteless, and colorless. And it makes you hallucinate.
What are you getting at?
Acid is soaked into my stationery.
This is LSD? I read about that in the newspapers, for crying out loud.
All right now. Come on. Sit down. Lie down. All right now. You are going on a trip. If you fight it, it can be a bad trip. If you ride with the waves, it will be a good trip.
Cabaldo, I told you to keep this ship steady.
It is steady, sir.
Are you contradicting me?
Sorry, sir, you're right. There's a strong wind coming from the northeast.
I don't care where it's from. Stop it.
10,000 more you owe me.
10,000 more, right? 10,000 more I owe you. Rack 'em up. Yes?
You've got visitors.
Visitors? Who? I'm not expecting any visitors. Who are they?
Me, God.
Just that Angie, bright kid, but stupid. Hey, who are the girls you got with you?
This one is a boy.
A boy? Go up and frisk the guy with him. So now you're bringing guided tours to my yacht,
huh?
Suddenly you're in the travel business.
I'm sorry, sir.
Now why don't you tell the whole world my longitude and latitude?
This is Tough Tony's daughter.
Oh, of course, Dorothy, yes.
Darlene.
Tough Tony's kid. How's your mother?
You know my mother?
Sure, she's quite a dame.
Well, I've come about my father.
You're a hippie, ain't you?
If labeling is your thing, yes.
And what does a hippie want from God?
A world where people can do their thing and not be hassled. Where nobody's uptight or paranoid about being together so we can all groove and dig ourselves for what we are, living things.
Very groovy.
Also, a safe place for butterflies, organic supermarkets, better bodies for women.
What's wrong with my body?
Do you like money?
Who doesn't?
I'll have a proposition for you tomorrow.
He's clean. Will you please tell me what happened to my father?
Of course. Give her a hot bath and send her in.
Hot bath?
He's afraid of germs.
I still don't feel anything.
It takes a little while. You'll know when it happens.
I don't feel a thing, I'm telling you. I don't feel anything. You'll make that damn fool out of me.
Some people can resist the effect of the drug, Tony. You are very strong-willed. You may have a high ego retention. Most members of the establishment have. They don't realize the beauty of life without ego. They don't realize the beauty of an egoless life.
I'm on a trip.
Tough Tony. Your time has come, wherein all things are like the void and cloudless sky. And the naked, spotless intellect is like a transparent vacuum.
Professor, I'm scared.
You need not be frightened. Just remember, wherever you go, you're still here.
Reach. Reach.
Oh, Tough Tony, the time has come to seek out the clear light. The light is the flame of your life. Your energy is the life process. Do not fear it. Surrender to it. Join it. It is part of you. You are part of it. Remember the final reality, the all good. The all-peaceful, the light, the radiance, let mind and body separate.
What's he see?
Shh. I see mathematics. Mathematics.
Mathematics.
Shh. He's got a loose screw. Playing your game.
Go ahead. Drop.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
Look for yourself now, Tony. Find yourself in the water.
Daddy?
No kid of mine could be that pretty.
Daddy?
No kid of mine could be that pretty. It's a father's right to know. It's a father's right to know.
I'll never have to stay up nights and worry about my clothes. I'd rather live the simple life than think about my dough. So look, my old pal Tony, and see how much you've missed. I can buy and sell 100 girls and pay to have me kissed.
You?
No comment, no comment, no comment, no comment.
I refuse to answer on the grounds that it may tend to incriminate some.
No. I've got a right to know. It's a father's right to know.
Would you please repeat the question?
Who were you with the night of?
With you, honey boy. You're my Daddy Waddams.
And who were you with the night of?
Daddy?
With you, Dickie Boom Boom.
You're under oath. I want the truth.
The truth is often stranger than you. Lots of things.
Please, tell me.
You really want to know? All right, I'll tell you.
No, don't tell me. Don't tell me. I don't care how many guys you slept with.
Haven't you ever noticed her ears? She's got your ears.
She's got my ears. She's got my ears. She's got my ears. She's got my ears. She's got my ears. She's got my ears. She's got my ears.
Tony, I've been wanting to tell you this for a long time. I think she looks like me. Sorry, Tony. It was just one of them things.
What's the matter now?
He did it. He lost his ego.
I want a flower.
Hey, Leach, give him a flower.
Huh?
Flower.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Huh?
Oh.
Would you like a little drinky?
No, thanks.
How about a baked potato with sour cream?
No.
They're good. Would you like to shoot a game of pool?
Where's my father?
Look, don't worry about him.
I am worried.
Don't worry. Your old man don't hide easy. You know he once was the best torpedo in the business.
Where is he?
Well, he's in prison.
In prison?
Yeah, well, what's so terrible about that? At least it's on solid ground. At least there he can shoot a game of pool.
My father in prison?
Just for a few days. I sent him there to knock off one of the inmates.
To what?
Like I said, he was the best torpedo in the business. The fact that I sent him shows how much I think of him. Believe me, I wish I could have gone myself. Right now, I'd rather be doing what he's doing than what I'm doing.
Hey! Now, cool it, baby. Hang loose, huh?
Wait for me! Hey, wait for me! Wait for me! Hey, wait for me! What the...
God wants you upstairs.
Hey, hang loose, would you?
What's wrong with my body?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
You know, I never met anyone like you before.
Oh, hey, there's lots like me.
Yeah, but you're here.
Cut it out, huh?
Relax. I'm very good at this.
Oh, I think I'm getting seasick.
Don't fight it.
Almost 10 years I've been on this thing. 10 years without seeing daylight.
But you can go up on deck.
You crazy? There's 9 guys in the crew. What's the odds of one of them trying to bump me off?
9-1.
Yeah, and you think that's good odds, eh?
Stop it.
I ain't taking no 9-1 odds, not me. I don't go up there, and they can't get in here.
But Elizabeth can.
Well, Elizabeth, I trust. We happen to be going steady. 10 years I've been on this thing. Do you know what I'd give to go to a racetrack or a ball game? You know how much Dramamine I gotta take? Ah, oh, it's a lousy way to get old.
Please let me go, please.
No, not on the lips.
Then let me go for crying out loud.
Blackmail, eh? All right. Go.
Every little cranny. Good news, Tony. I got good news. It's all arranged. You're gonna take Packard his breakfast. Here's a trustee's armband for you. Here's a trustee's cap. And here, I don't mind telling you, this took a little doing. With him?
I don't know. I think he ate something.
Tony? Tony, can you hear me?
I hear you.
Well, this is no time to get cold feet. In 20 minutes, you kiss Packard. An hour after that, you're on your way home.
I'm not kissing Packard.
Come on, Tony. There's no time to kid around.
I'm not kissing anyone.
Now, you don't mean that. You got to be realistic, Tony. I'm asking you to be realistic. All right, don't do it, you dumb slob. Stay here for the rest of your life and rot.
Ada!
If you don't care for yourself, you could at least think about your daughter.
What does that mean?
Well, she's on the big boat. Packard expects his cornflakes in 20 minutes.
Consolation. There's no problem I can't solve.
Hey, maybe if I take some of that stuff, I wouldn't have to rape anybody anymore.
Good morning, Skipper.
Oh, good morning, sir.
Any news?
The stock market is holding its own.
Oh, splendid. Okay, here it is.
What? Who?
I got the whole deal linked up. We'll stop at 36 key cities. You set up a contact in each one. Doesn't have to be a hippie. Anybody can grow his hair.
What are you talking about, man?
The youth market. Half the country is under 25. $1 billion market. I supply the stuff. You get it to the customers. In the first year, you'll make $150,000.
No, thanks.
What do you mean? You said you like money.
Sure. But business bores me.
Oh, boy. Yeah?
Tony is now Marshmallow Tony.
What? What?
He says he won't do it.
What do you mean he won't do it?
My God, I tried everything. I tried coercion.
Never mind coercion. You tell him Packard better not live through the day. Get it? Angie! Angie, where are you? Angie!
In my cabin.
I can't see you. What's wrong with this thing?
What thing?
Probably needs a new tube. Damn gadgets. Electronics I need. You sure your lights are on?
Daytime. The sun's shining. Let me see if I can fix this thing.
That's it. You've got it. Angie, believe me, no matter how long I live, I can't get used to being double-crossed.
Me? I would never.
Not you, idiot. Tony, he won't kiss Packard.
But he's gotta.
Yeah. Hey, you like this kid of his?
Sort of.
Okay. If Tony comes through, she's yours.
What if he don't?
Well, then you got a little job to do.
Lithuanian measles.
Isolation ward.
Genius. We drink aftershave lotion, we break out in red spots. Instead of being locked up day, we're locked up here.
The spots will be gone in 28 minutes. Just what I thought. Steel spoke ventilation system. Thank you. Okay, hoist me up.
Blood is kind of dark. John, could you give him more oxygen?
More oxygen, doctor.
Still dark, John. Oxygen.
Clamp.
More oxygen.
Clamp.
Sponge.
More. Doctor.
Tony, Tony, come on, let's
get
moving. I thought you'd never get here, but fine. Now, well, I'm freezing to death.
This is no time to feel sorry for yourself.
I make it a point to eat with the men at least once a month, Senator.
That's a good idea, Warden.
Let them know that what's good enough for their stomachs is good enough for mine.
That's what democracy is all about, right, Warden?
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I've got news for you.
Password!
It's me! I forgot it. That guy with the hair.
What about him?
I just bumped into him. He said to tell you he thinks he can swing his end of the deal.
Yeah?
Only he's got to make a phone call to be sure.
If only I could find a place where smiling strangers knew our faces, I would take you there. A place with constant melody where you and I could
wander free. Xerox me, man. I don't want to be misquoted.
I would take you there.
Dig the spirit of St. Louis, man. Yeah, like Greeley says, what's seven or eight Dukes of Windsor when it's Mona Lisa time, huh? Yeah, take a bow and arrow. And we're not getting any younger, right? So come in X-17. Over.
Son of nowhere, you're loud and clear. Cool is everything.
Over and out.
What'd he say?
Oh, he says he'll have to get back to me.
Spirit of St. Louis, Lindbergh.
Kidnapped.
Who?
Mona Lisa.
Yours.
Darlene. They got Darlene.
Calm. Bow and arrow, they're armed, but where?
Horace Greeley said go west, young man.
He did, and how far west? Windsor.
Knots.
Water, children, water. 7 to 8 knots west of... What? That's the hole. X-17. Think. X-17.
X could mean used to be.
17. The old pier. Pier 17.
As soon as I'm president, it's yours.
Two convicts to every cell. Use computers to be sure they're compatible. Murderer bumps murderer. Sex maniac with sex maniac.
Democrat with Democrat. Republican with Republican.
Are you going to run for the big office?
Not quite yet. But I've been working on my acceptance speech for the last 5 years.
My men are going to learn to express themselves.
Hello, Americans! We are living in perilous times!
We're going to have finger painting and modern dance.
There are only three great Americans, Washington, Lincoln, and me.
Gordon, can I have your keys?
I'm going to teach them to make costume jewelry, and they can even design their own uniform.
You ain't Loretta. You ain't Loretta. Loretta!
Wait a minute, he is Loretta Gertrude.
I thought me and you got it.
Beanie?
Hello, hello. Hello, hello. I can't hear you. Is the man there? I want to talk to the man.
Mr. Nguyen.
Who's this? What's going on?
That's more than 10 words.
I want to talk to the man.
Soup.
Oh, hello. Hello, hello. There's got to be somebody there. It's a federal prison, and I'm a taxpayer.
Soup.
Hello, hello. I can't hear you.
They're playing our song.
I can't hear it.
Like a flower.
That's funny. I feel like a flower. Hey, get the noise down. You'll wake the baby.
Where is it?
The Green Bay Packers.
Living in a garbage can be a lot of fun. It has its ups. Doo-doo-doo-doo and downs. Old paper cups and coffee grounds.
Do you hear what I hear? I hear nothing.
A lot of fun, especially if you meet the perfect onion. Oh, the great garbage can is just full of good stuff. All the discarded refuse of man.
Nothing.
Like the half-used banana whose girlfriend is Anna. Who shout, let us out of this can. Long, 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 said the poor Brussels sprout.
Dibbity-bye.
If only me and the banana could get out, we'd find an asparagus who'd stand up and marry us. But the first thing to do is get out. Long, long, long. Now an old piece of ham is in love with some lamb. But a young head of lettuce is too. And I said the ham to the lettuce, the lamb will forget us. I
as soon as he learns I love you. Oh, oh, oh. The great garbage can, dibbity-bye. It's a tribute to the ingenuity of man. Where corn and tomatoes are mixed with potatoes and thrown in together with ham. Where a Brussels sprout and a sauerkraut can get together and have it out, and no one seems to care about the plan. And a succotash and a piece of hash can get together and have a bash, for life is always equal in the can.
Find out. I'll get you for this.
Yeah?
Hello, hello.
Hello.
I'm inquiring about the health of one of the inmates.
Which one?
Mr. Packard.
Who's this?
Who's this?
God?
Packard?
I never felt better in my life.
Don't count on it.
Lousy crumb.
Dirty stool pigeon.
I'm sorry, we are unable to complete your call at this time. Please press the number below and the operator's
assistant. Hey, come out here. You see what I see? Scrambled eggs. No, Jell-O. Reminds me of my wife.
Okay, Tony, let's go.
What about me?
Sorry, we can't take you.
You're too heavy.
Man wasn't meant to fly. He wasn't meant to go up in the sky.
Man wasn't meant for such things.
If God wanted man to fly, we'd have wings.
Do you see what I see? It's a balloon. Now, it's a big, beautiful blob of nothing. It wants me. It wants me. It loves me. Yeah, but why is it going away?
I see it. I see it.
Too bad at that.
The bridge! Look out for the bridge!
I know I should have never done this.
It's just another trip, Tony.
Another trip to you. And not like you, it's another trip. Can't you fly it a little closer to the ground?
All right.
Wait a minute, not
that close.
Oh, take it off.
Okay,
it
off. Okay, okay.
Tony let us down.
Yes, sir.
Sir, looks like friendly natives.
Friendly what? Holy hell, Gabalo, stop them.
Hold on there. Ahoy! Ahoy!
Never mind, ahoy. Tell them to beat it or else. Okay, this is it. Ready? Hey.
What's that? It's a
balloon! Hey! Hold the balloon!
Don't
grab your
boat, sir!
Fire!
Which way, sir?
The balloon! Kill the balloon!
There! They missed!
Oh, no! What's the matter with you? I'm talking to you.
Put them both together and we love them to death. Believe it really is the thing to do. Skidoo, skidoo, and the world can be a better place for you. Well, you gotta be good and you gotta be kind, but there's a lot of people think they gotta draw the line. They separate the good, the bad, the wrong from right. They forget about the colors between the black and white.
Skidoo, Skidoo, the only thing that matters is who you choose. Skidoo, Skidoo,
only thing that matters.
Dolly!
Are you dirty?
No, Daddy, no,
it
saved my life!
Skidoo, I do really agree. I do believe it really is the thing to do. Skidoo, Skidoo. Between the 1-3, there is a 2. Look around, and if you open your eyes, you may begin to think you shouldn't criticize the way another person wants to wear his hair. But in the overall analysis, the only thing that counts is the magic and the love you share. Skidoo, Skidoo, the only thing that matters is with who you do. Skidoo, Skidoo, the only thing that matters is with who Skidoo. Can be a better place for you. Time is moving fast and there's a lot to see, so don't you trap yourself inside a boat that's floating on the sea. There's a better way of living if you take the time to try to live and love and take a breath and watch the scenery as the color slowly changes from 14 to 23. Skidoo, Skidoo.
Where's God?
Skidoo.
Where's God? Hey, you. Where's God?
Does anybody
around here know where God is?
Skidoo, and the world can be a better place for you. Skidoo,
will you give this ring as a symbol of your affection, sincerity, and fidelity?
I will.
Will you receive this ring and wear it as a symbol of your affection, sincerity, and fidelity?
I will.
And now, I pronounce you man and wife.
Congratulations, daughter.
Stash, girlie.
We are gathered here today to join this brother and this sister in holy union.
If only I could find a place where smiling strangers knew our faces, I would take you there. With constant melody, where you and I could wander free.
Pumpkin.
I would take you there.
Stop! We are not through yet. And before you, Skidoo, we'd like to introduce our cast and crew.
Jackie Gleason was Tony Banks, Carol Channing Flo, Frankie Avalon and G. Fred Clark, a tower guard, Michael Constantine Leach, Frank Gorshin, the man, John Phillip Law, Stash, Peter Lawford, the senator, Burgess Meredith, the warden, George Raft, the skipper, Cesar Romero as head chief, Mickey Rooney, Blue Chips Packard, and Groucho Marx played God in the Otto Preminger film Skidoodly-Doo-Doo-Doo. With Arnold Stang as Harry, Doran Miranda as the mayor, Phil Arnold as her husband, Slim Pickens as a switchboard operator, Robert Donner as another switchboard operator, Richard Keel as Beanie, Tom Law as Geronimo, Jake Rosenstein as Eggs, Benedict, Stacey King as the Amazon, and Benny Roker as a prison guard, Roman Gabriel as a prison guard, and Nilsson as a tower guard, and Stone Country as themselves, and the Orange County Ramblers play the Green Bay Packers. And introducing Austin Pendleton as Fred, Alexandra Hay as Darlene, and Luna as God's mistress. Well, you know what I mean. Music and lyrics by Nilsson, who also played a tower guard, arranged and conducted by George Tipton, a very good friend. Choreography, Tom Hansen. Costumes, Rudy Gernreich.
photographed in Panavision and Technicolor, director of photography, Leon Shamroy, ASC. Sound, Len Anderson, Franklin Milton, and Lloyd Hanks. Thanks, camera operators, Irving Rosenberg and Doobie Wrigley. Chief electrician, Fred Hall. Key grip, Leo McCrary. Transportation, George Cole. Editor, George Rose. Assistant editor, Dean Ball. Music editor, Fred Fryer. Sound effects editor, Don Higgins. Negative cutter, Connie Rose. And script supervisor, Kathleen Fagan.
Oh, boy.
Art director, Robert E. Smith. Assistant art director, Jay Monty Elliott. Set decorator, Fred Price. Special effects, Charles Spurgeon. Painter, Eugene Acker. Property master, Kenny Westcott. Commercials by John Urich. Executive assistant to the producer, Nat Rudick. Dialogue coach, Max Slater. Story and casting, Eric Kirkland. Production managers, Kenny DeLand and Howard Joslin. Assistant directors, Eric von Stroheim, Jr., Wally Jones, Al Murphy, and Stephen North. Production accountant, Herman Darstein. Production secretary, Joyce Lilly. Costume coordinator, Hope Bryce. Makeup, Webb Overlander. Hairdressing, Vivian Thompson. Wardrobe, Ted Parvin, Phyllis Garr, George Thompson, and John Perry. Visual consultant and titles by Sandy DeVore. And what's more, they were executed by Pacific. How's your popcorn? Copyright MCMLXBIII by Sigma Productions Incorporated. Your seat's on fire. The story, the characters, and the incidents are fictitious. Ho hum, et cetera, et cetera. It's a Paramount TM release, a Gulf Plus Western company, written by Mr. Doran William Cannon. Produced and directed by Otto Preminger.